Hey guys, what's up? Neil here. I'd like to share a tool with you guys. I've been using this tool for quite some time now, for many years. And maybe some of you doesn't know about this tool. And I seldom use this tool, and unfortunately, the thing that I wasn't expecting today happened. Okay. I'm referring to a tool that I used to a tool that can fix corrupted MP4 files. So I'm not sure why the DVR recording on my goggles actually got corrupted. I have no idea why. I'm gonna open up the file, or maybe kind of like similar to Windows Explorer, because right now I'm on Debian Linux. So I'm gonna show you a corrupted MP4 file. So yeah, the tool that I'm gonna teach you is used for fixing corrupted MP4 files. All right. So I just found out about the corrupted file about like 5 minutes ago. So I'm not sure what's going on. And then, oops. How come my machine is so slow? It is so slow. Huh? I couldn't even. Oh, there you go. I thought I was dragging it. Sorry about that. So, this sim. If you notice, all of the other files, other MP4 files, that's sorted by type, you can see a thumb, right? A thumbnail. But I have one file here that doesn't have any thumbnail. This is from today. And if I double click it, nothing happens. It doesn't open up the player. If I double click this file, it's gonna open up the open source MPV file, right? Yeah, right here. Okay. So, oh my God, by the way, before I start the tutorial on fixing MP4 files, I'd like to mention my new friend. His name is Brad. His YouTube channel name is JINXFPV. You guys have to visit his page. And this guy is phenomenal. So he brought us here. This place is an abandoned building. Nobody works here anymore, okay? It's in Northbrook. Specifically, the building is CVS, all right? And you should visit this place only on weekends to make sure there's no people around. But anyways, let's open up Chrome browser, and I'm just gonna show you real quick. Sorry for derailing, because I'd like to show you. Yeah, the place, it is phenomenal, right? Oh, right here. Okay. Oh, is it right there? Oh yeah, okay, it's here. Let's bring it here. All right, cool. Maps, and then it's not CVS, it's called Joint. Is it Joint? Joint Relief Institute in Northbrook. Okay, and then yeah, that's the place. We're gonna put this thing here. I think the yeah, so I don't know if we'll be able to. Yeah, we should put the man here so we can see the. This was like years ago, that's why there's scars. Yep, that's the one I was showing above here. Yeah, this one, right? You're awesome, Brad. Thank you for bringing us here. Yeah, this was like taking shots like a long time ago. That's why there are people, but this is abandoned. This is most likely pre-COVID. But anyways, yeah, this is the video. And yeah, I don't have to play. I'm just cruising. Okay. All right. So, what I would like to oh, before we head to just to the tutorial, let's visit Jinx. channel, YouTube channel, and you guys have to visit JINXFPV. This is his channel. He is phenomenal, guys. You should subscribe to his channel. He is phenomenal. All right, that's his channel, JINXFPV. All right, yeah, that's his channel. All right, so sorry for derailing you guys. I just want to share what we actually did earlier. So yeah, this is one of my recordings. Okay. Anyways, we don't need that anymore. So okay, I was talking about how to fix corrupted MP4 files. So let's open up a terminal and hopefully here, system LX terminal. Yeah, when it's recording, it's kind of slow. I'm recording this session, that's why the apps that I'm trying to open are kind of slow. So our camera, no, not that one, our camera. Media, and then the file that is broken is 88, right? This is 88. So let's see if FFmpeg can read it. Invalid, okay? It's invalid. Even the player that I'm gonna use, it won't be able to play it, I guess. Right, invalid format. So the tool that I'm gonna teach you today, it's called UNTRUNC. Okay, this is how it's spelled. UNTRUNC MP4. And then I'm on a Linux machine, so I may need to compile to make it work, but you can also just install using tools like yum or app. But in Windows, I don't know if there's a version for Windows. Let's see. Let me make it bigger. So Docker container, GUI. Oh, looks like, yeah, there's a Windows version. I've not been using Windows since 2009. I switched to Mac and Linux. I mean, I've been using Linux since 1995. But anyways, I'm going to use Docker container because I have a Docker here and I like Docker. Docker is a tool for launching containers, okay? So we will have to clone this. Clone meaning copy the repository, which is this one, UNTRUNC, and then copy it down, pull it down from the remote repository or registry, which is github.com, and then we will pull it down locally into my machine here. So I'm gonna make a new window. I don't wanna close that one. And then I'm gonna put it in repos. We're gonna make a tool, make the vid tools, cd vid tools, and then the tool for cloning, for people who don't know git, the command is git. So you guys have to install git command as well. So git clone is the parameter for pulling it down, and then, oops, not that one, you copy this thing, okay? Mine is SSH because I've configured my keys there. And I'm gonna pull it down, all right? So it was able to pull it down. And then in order to build the UNTRUNC container, let me show you. I don't have anything yet. I think I don't have let's see. Docker images. So Docker images is used to display all the Docker images that I have downloaded a long time ago. Let's see. Hello world, hypercube. Do I have UNTRUNC here? So these are the tools that I've been... Oh, I have UNTRUNC. Okay, let's remove UNTRUNC so you can see how it's done. Grab UNTRUNC. Docker RMI. I'm going to delete it. This one is old. See, 4 months ago. So we're gonna delete it so we can so I can show you how to install it using Docker from scratch. So we can follow the instruction from this browser. Yep, right here. Okay, if it's too small for your screen, there you go. That's the command, and I'm gonna copy Docker build. I don't have to specify. I can just use this. Okay, and then command C. I just copied it to my clipboard. All right, and then head back here, and then I'm gonna paste that command, that Docker build dash the UNTRUNC, and then. But let me, before we compile it, I wanna run this command again to show you that it's been removed. Okay, it doesn't show up anymore compared to this one, right? So yep. So yep. So we have deleted the original. I mean the old image. So we're going to build it now. So when compiling or when making Docker images, it usually reads the file Docker file. Yeah, this one. Okay, and then let me open up code. This is Microsoft Visual Studio Code. They have a version for Linux and code, which is a binary to launch VS Code, and I just included it in the path, so that's why I can launch code like this. All right, so what I did here is I just told code, hey, please open up this directory, and I'm referring to this directory, the UNTRUNC directory, so right here, so that we can see the Docker file. I can use VI, right? But I'd rather choose code because of like color highlighting. It's nicer. Okay, let's click this file. All right, so this one is gonna pull an Ubuntu image, Bionic, and then it's gonna call it as build, and then it's gonna run update so that it will be able to install other newer files that may be not present in the Ubuntu Bionic, and then it's gonna start this make, which is a tool that comes with GCC. That's a GNU compiler, and yeah, and then it's gonna put it in the bin trunk. Okay, but this is all going to be part of the Docker image. So you know what? You know, let's start now. So I'm gonna paste the command that I copied earlier. Or yeah, this one. Let's see. I don't know how long this will take. Maybe I should time lapse it so you guys don't have to wait. So yeah. So look, this command that you're seeing is the same command that's being displayed on the left side, right? But this one is just running, and then it's downloading from remote registry. So yeah, what I'm doing is I'm compiling it so that I can have a local Docker UNTRUNC image. And again, UNTRUNC is used to fix corrupted MP4 files. So let us see where our browser is. Where is our browser? Yeah, here. Okay. Yeah. I'm looking for the browser, not this one. Where's the browser? UNTRUNC here. Oh, it's right there. Where is it? Oh, right here. So here. So let's read the top part of the what UNTRUNC does. UNTRUNC. Restore a damaged MP4. Oh, it can do M4B, MOV, and other formats. This is nice. So the way for it to work, the way to fix your corrupted MP4 files or video files, you have to have a working file in order to make the corrupted file fix. I think what UNTRUNC does is it tries to capture the metadata that is recorded in the working MP4 file. It's not gonna copy the video, but I'm referring to like other formats that are required. So it's gonna fix, maybe it's gonna fix the header, maybe the header, like what you saw earlier, it was saying move atom cannot be found. So I guess that's one of the things that is going to be fixed. So yeah, that's what UNTRUNC does. And hopefully this tool will work for the one that I was showing earlier. It's still compiling. Okay. So yeah, this is the one. Look again, see? See this icon? Yeah, there's no thumbnail. And we are going to use this file. Or maybe this file. These are all Cadex Vista recording. They are all 60 FPS, 720p. So I don't have to use a really big file like the 1.3 gig on the right side, right? Yeah, like this. I can use this. I can use an even smaller file like 81, as long as it's playable. So, yep, so like that. Cool, all right. So what's that file? So it's going to be quicker. 81 meg, that would be DJI G0080, and then we're going to fix 88. Okay. All right, guys, it's still compiling. So sorry for the wait. I mean, I just want to show you how it's done from scratch. And hopefully, guys, this will work for you. And like what I said, let's go back to the other page here. There is a, oh, about this. Oh, there's a fork. Improve the original. Okay. So there is a version for Windows. Oh yeah, here for you Windows users, you can click this. Okay. And then assets. There you go. Don't download the source code because so that you don't have to compile. And then download the 64-bit. And maybe this will work for Windows 95. So download the 64-bit version, okay? And then what other CentOS, this is Linux as well. What is this GUI is optional? Oh, this is just like a user interface in GUI format, okay? Docker container, yeah, so this is what we're doing. We're building it, and then I don't have to do this. Okay, and then this is how you format. So we will specify a video path. This is a path, and this is where you want the how do you call that thing? Maybe I'll call it fake directory inside a container. Actually, it's a real directory, but it's kind of like a what's that term? Like temporary directory, something like that. And then this is the image name, and then you're telling it to hey, please read this good file, and then we'll be specifying our broken file here, which is the 88. Okay, so simple. Oh my god, it's still taking a while. You know what, let's do this. While we are waiting, I'm just gonna do a history and find out how many times I run UNTRUNC before. Oh, okay. Yeah, I fixed a few files. Most likely I have more in my Mac laptop, but I stopped using the laptop because it was owned by the company, it's an office laptop, so I don't want to use it anymore. So I started using my Linux, and yeah, this is an old Linux from 2009, but it's still powerful. Although I've noticed some some degradation issues. No, not degradation. It's having a hard time. How do you call this? Re-encoding 4K files, because even if it's an i7 CPU, it's not meant for the newer MP4 resolutions like 4K. But yeah, so okay, our compile of UNTRUNC is done, so it's been built, so we should see it now as an image, docker grep. If you recall earlier, it was missing earlier, right? Now, see, it's 36 seconds, it's up there. So now, we're going to switch to my the SD card where the corrupted file is located, as well as the good files. Okay, so that's where it's located, and then the bad file is this one, and then the good file is, we'll pick 80, okay, because that's small. All right, so the command would be docker minus v. And then V is meant for mounting a volume. When we say volume, it's just like a directory. And we are going to mount this path, this directory. And then I'm going to mount it in MNT folder internally. Even if it doesn't exist inside the container, this directory will be created. Okay? And then we need to specify the image UNTRUNC, which is what you saw earlier, right? And then we're going to specify the good file. So MNT in the documentation was ok.mp4, but for us, we're going to specify this file. And then the bad file, we're going to specify this. Okay? Let's hope it works. Why? What did I miss? Oh, I forgot the word run. That's funny. I wanted to show the version. There you go. So yeah, 30. Hopefully, I'm not sure if it's going to work, but 99% of the time, yeah, this, I got lucky here. I was able to recover them. So let's hope. It's just a small file. It's about 900. What is it? 987. Yeah, it's not bad. Okay. Let's see what it's doing. I think it's creating a file or directory. No, not yet. Maybe it's still reading. I'm on the same path. And we can see UNTRUNC here being executed. Yeah, right? There you go. Oh, it's saving now. Fixed. There you go. Two warnings were hidden. Oh, it's done. Let's see. Oh, look at that. See, guys? There's now a thumbnail. There's a thumbnail now. Told you this UNTRUNC tool is phenomenal. I hope you guys are thankful for what I did here. And then what we're gonna do now, if you remember earlier, we ran FFmpeg and it says move atom could not be found. So it created this file, right? Nice. It's now red. Okay? Not bad at all. Sweet. And then MPV. We're gonna play it. Oops. Let's hope it's gonna be. Oh, there you go. So how many? Oh, 5 minutes? 900? That's kind of weird. 985 meg for a 5 minute? I don't know. Oh, looks like it's the same. Maybe it's the same file. I don't know why it duplicated. Yeah, I was waiting for Serge here or for Mike. They were behind me. I think we're gonna. Oh, there you go. There he is. Because I don't know where he was at, so and I was slowing down. Oh, there you go. There's him. Yeah, man, I gotta buy a new lens. Look at this. It's so cloudy. There's so many scratches. Yep. And then this one, this black thing here, it's been there since 2001 or 2000. Yeah, what's this thing? So I stop. I don't know why. I don't know what's going on here. Hey, I think I was talking to them. Hey, where are you guys? Where are you? So, yep, that's cool, man. Yeah, I don't know. Let's forward. That's crap. What is this thing? Oh, you know what? I actually crashed hard today and something's wrong with my flight controller. I could not orbit anymore properly. It's weird. It's so weird. Yeah. Anyways, yeah, so it was really fun. Really had fun flying with FLYZONE drones and JINXFPV today. Yeah, JINXFPV, yeah, there we are. That's where we were. Oh, sorry. How come it's so... Pause. Oh! Ooh, look at that, that's Mike. That's me sitting down. Yeah. Oh, I think JINX... FAB already left here. Yeah, this was like around past 1 p.m. But anyways, so looks like that file, yeah, the one that we just fixed, is kind of like a duplicate of this. I'm pretty sure it's the same. I don't know why my DJI FAB goggles duplicated it. That's weird, because I'm pretty sure it's the same. Let's see. Maybe it's not. I don't know. This one is 4 minutes. The other one is 5 minutes 12, right? Oh, by the way, the playback is slow because I'm recording the whole screen. Oh, no. This is a different video. Yeah, this is a different video. I was waiting for someone. Yeah, there he is. There you go. And then I thought he was going to follow me, so I had to enter here. Yeah, that's the one I was telling you guys, that I have to buy a new lens. See? Oh. See that thing? That blob? It's actually one of accidents that I encountered about a year ago. And it's not annoying, but it's just $9. Maybe I should buy. I don't know. We'll see. Cool, man. All right. So again, this is the tool. I'm going to share it in the description of my video on UNTRUNC. And then what I showed you today is how to build it and then install it as a Docker container. Okay? And then the reason why I like Docker container is because I can just, like what I said earlier, clone from another machine like Windows or Mac, and then it will build the same thing. Yep, it's really cool. It's very portable. Yep. So, yep, this is it. Cool, man. All right, so I'm gonna process all my rips tonight, and hopefully I'll be able to upload it tonight as well. Maybe, I don't know, because my machine is slow. Anyways, I am hoping you guys enjoyed this video. All right, adios. Thank you.